Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Woodville and our Down. We stand here today to demand our civil and religious liberty to walk home. Today, we are now on another crisis, and this excuse for democracy. And what I'm going to say is personal to me. I don't want the press run to the Grand Lodge and saying, is this your policy? This is what I believe. First of all, that democracy, which is supposedly a storming, was created by gerrymandering. What do I mean by gerrymandering? 108 MLAs to look after 1.5 million people, where Wales with 3.5 million and only 60. Scotland have 6 million, and they have only got 130. If you work hard, either we have 54, we'd still be oversubscribed. What I'm saying is, brother, when they go into negotiations, you scrap the Good Friday Agreement, they talk about St Andrews, they talk about Elsborough. The mistake was made when Tony Blair told us lies for St Andrews for him. He said it was the only way we go forward. Well, why? Opinion is this, that our politicians should go in and say, right, enough is enough, go back to the drawing board, let's have democracy, true democracy. 54 MLAs, up to 3 for every of the 18 constituencies in the Westminster election. Brother, we hear about austerity. Martin McGuinness and Quick tells about austerity. Well, we would cut the bill for government in this country in half if we had 54. And the money could go to help to relieve austerity with our people. Brother, I'm glad to see the Carrick Fergus bond here today with us. I think we should give him a round of applause. Very famous place, Carrick Fergus. People tell you that's where King William landed. Well, long before that, Carrickfergus was famous. Carrickfergus means the rock of Fergus. Fergus O'Moore, who was king of Dalriada and the Scots, he went across to Scotland, and his descendants founded the Royal House of Scotland when Count McAlpine, one of his descendants, ascended the throne and led the people of Scotland to be King of the Scots. He brought with him the fear. What is the fear? The fear is the coronation stone. And that is a symbol of the United Kingdom. Why? Well, of course, it came from here. It went across to Scotland. Edward the First took it down to England. Edward the First gave it the first Prince of Wales. That is a symbol of the United Kingdom. Brown. And also, Carrickfergus was where Fergus was washed off the rock and he's buried on the foothills of Naga, just above Monkstown. Carrickfergus also has links with Robert de Bruce and Edward de Bruce. Robert de Bruce was the Earl of Kerry. He became the King of Scotland. The Queen can trace her ancestry right back to Fergus O'Moore. And Fergus O'Moore claimed that he was the 36th generation removed from Zara, son of Judah. That's not British Israelites. Israelites hadn't even thought about that at that time. They were Hebrews. Round. Our history is rich, very rich. And we are demanding that we maintain our history. We have paid, our forefathers have paid with their blood for the freedom which we do not enjoy now because of people who manipulated the electoral system. Brown, stand up and true to yourself. Stand up for Jesus, ye soldiers of the cross. Lift high his royal banner. It must not suffer loss. We do that, Lord. We will succeed. Not by our hand, but by the hand of God. Lord, thank you again for turning up. And now, One other fact, Brown. Last Sunday, as usual, the BBC got it wrong. They said the man who composed the Bed With Me came from Scotland. He didn't. He came from Ireland, was educated at the Tory Royal School in Enniskill. Again, they got it wrong. Brown. National Anthem of the United Kingdom.